was courageous, but now I know I want to be like Manana when I grew up. Let me just say to everyone first, Eid Mubarak. It's so special for us. It's Christmas. And every day we thank you. I want to thank Fox Searchlight and Manana for having you here this evening. It is on the eve of a very special day. It is historic, and for those of you that have been with us on the last 3.5 years, it's been a long road for the UN, together with everyone, to frame a new agenda that hopes to give the right things that we need to do for a life of peace, of justice, for rights for everyone. And so when I look at the film today and I listen to the words that you have, I know that what we've done is respond to all those challenges, as complex as they are. As though there is no light at the end of the tunnel, what we intend to do tomorrow is to have our leaders adopt an agenda with 17 incredible goals that bring back that light at the end of the tunnel, that bring back hope. The world as it is, and the world as it should be, and what the UN is trying to do is to bring them closer together. And we hope that we will continue together to try to walk that path. It's a 15-year journey. It took 3.5 years to get it as it is. But it's a 15-year journey, so the day after tomorrow, what are we up to? We have to go back to our countries. We have to call our leaders to have the same courage. Just even an ounce of what Malala has would be good. But to really have the courage to live up to their words. They're there to serve people. They're there to ensure that what we see as conflict today is no more tomorrow. And that we really need to look at the root causes, not just to put a band-aid on a problem today that comes off tomorrow, because it does mean lives. It means the lives of those children that won't have an education. It means the lives of those children that won't aspire to have what they should have as a right. It's not about children deserve it, it's about children's rights. And so for us, it's the very foundation of what we believe is our humanity. And for that, the UN is grateful to Malala. We will have you tomorrow at the opening. And it's because the Secretary General believes that the youth are the torchbearers of the 2030 agenda. And we're going to put our actions where our words are. You're going to start by telling us tomorrow exactly what that is about, with 193 other young people in the world who all mean business. Because young people's lives are not about tomorrow, they're about today. And I think Malala proved that to us, that it is about every day of our lives. It is about the life that you chose. You're right, it's the path that you've chosen. But I'm sure that after tonight, many of you will know that the conviction she has for the 12 years of education that will become a reality, because there are goals there that will make that happen, is a journey that you will help us tread as we go up to 15 years down the road. People ask us whether, do you think this is too heavy and this is too big an agenda and will we achieve it? Please don't start to fail before we start. If Malala had started to fail before she started, she might have been. Challenge us to do what we have started off doing, which is being inclusive and bringing you all into the UN and taking the UN out to you. But that this journey will not just be about us, it'll be about everyone, everywhere. And Malala, thank you so much for being who you are.
Thank you.